I'm Mashu Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Hey guys, Sam Pardee here. I'm going to be recording some modern with hopefully an updated pod deck that works out well. I'm not sure exactly where pod wants to be in the new Treasure Cruise metagame. So this is my first attempt, which I didn't change a ton. I added Spirit of the Labyrinth to help hate on not only Treasure Cruise, but it hates on Jeskai Ascendancy. It hates on like all the cantrips that go into the Treasure Cruise deck. The other problem is that Treasure Cruise, the other cards that synergize with Treasure Cruise, other than cheap cantrips, are one mana removal spells, all of which are pretty good at killing Spirit of the Labyrinth. So I'm a little concerned on that front that it might not be enough, but it's where I'm going to start for now. The rest of the deck is pretty unchanged. I was thinking originally about cutting a voice, but I decided not to because the decks that I expect to benefit from Treasure Cruise are the Delver, like blue-red, you know, whatever, Snapcaster Lightning Bolt decks, which voice is excellent against, and the Jeskai Ascendancy deck, which voice is not great against. But I think that I'd rather keep that blue-red matchup intact, and, you know, hopefully it's okay with some voices and the Spirit of the Labyrinth and all that sort of stuff. I also removed the Metamorph that has been in the build for a long time, just to make space for Spirit. So that was basically the change there. And then in the mana base, I cut the Misty Rainforest for Windswept Heath. And I had a second Temple Garden that I've cut for a Plains so that Windswept Heath can fetch a basic. So now you have a basic of every type, so the deck should be a little more resilient to Tectonic Edge. And you can, you know, all your fetch lands can still fetch a green land. So hopefully that works out. The board looks pretty much the same. I'd been playing a Kataki in this spot, but I switched it to a Canonist to hate on the Jeskai Ascendancy deck. I still don't expect that matchup to be like amazing for us, but it might be okay. I might also consider adding Thalia somewhere in the deck. It's another card that's good against the blue-red Delver deck. If the Spirit doesn't work out, great, or if it's okay, but I feel like I want more of that effect. Like, I'd rather have one Spirit, one Thalia, than two of either to start. Just because I would imagine that most of the time, you know, you'd rather have a mix. So, yeah, let's get to it.